Hi there, Aries, and welcome back to Star-Lord is Tarot. This is your tarot forecast for the month of September 2021. I went ahead, shuffled the cards, laid them all out. Let's see what's going on for Aries. Your overall energy, Aries, you have the Eight of Swords in the upright position. Well, this is a card that can indicate a feeling, a level of being trapped in some respect. Sometimes the Eight of Swords is being trapped in our own mind where we can't seem to stop ruminating thoughts over and over again, can't get out of our own head. We're all capable of getting into this mindset from time to time. And it could be where sometimes with the Eight of Swords, it's like it's not only our own mind, but other people piping in at the same time can also add to the feeling of restriction. Now, remember, if this is just a mental prison that you have put yourself in, you can find your way out of it. There may be a little bit of a struggle trying to find answers or, you know, basically some kind of... It's like you have to try to find some kind of way out of the situation. Now, Aries, you use your mind quite a bit. You can figure out how, instead of sitting there dwelling upon why you're feeling restricted in this situation. Now, the restriction can come from anything from, you know, feeling restricted because we're in a relationship that feels extremely restrictive. It can be restrictive because we're in a workplace or a job situation that feels like there's no way out. You're going to have to search and find. I would suggest this month that you spend your time trying to figure an escape route out of whatever it is that is making you feel trapped in the situation. If it's your own head, try clearing your head with meditation or whatever it is that you go for walks, do whatever it is to get out of your own head. But if it's a situation, like a work situation, a health issue, financial issue, you have to start looking for escape routes, ways out of the problem. So in week one, Aries, we have the Four of Swords reversed, rooted down by the Five of Wands in the reverse. So the Four of Swords in the reverse can point to it's time to return to action. So maybe some of you have been feeling restricted in some way or another in terms of your, you know, physical being. Maybe you have been, you know, laid up or something like that. Now it's time to actually start, you know, get out there and start moving and getting things done. For others of you, the time has come for letting go of the sorrow, sadness of the past that, you know, if you went through a breakup or you went through something that put you in the Four of Swords in the upright position, it's time to start releasing that and start getting back into action again. It's rooted down here with Five of Wands in the reverse position. Well, the Five of Wands in the upright is a lot of drama. He said, she said, nonsense, people going back and forth and, you know what I mean? That kind of stuff where nothing ever really gets resolved. It's just a bunch of pantomime and nonsense when the card is in the upright. But when the card is reversed, this can indicate being released from that, being released from that drama. Maybe some of you are finally returning back into a situation because you've decided to let go of the drama or the competition, the stiff competition is now over and we need to move forward. So week two, we have the Two of Cups in the upright, rooted down by the Nine of Wands upright. Well, the Two of Cups is where we're on the same page with someone in week two. This could be some of you, perhaps if you're single and looking, maybe you're meeting somebody in the second week and the two of you are just getting along like two peas in a pod. For others of you, the Two of Cups could represent sort of teaming up with someone. This could be your best friend. This could be your business partner. This could be husband, wife, BFF, what have you. Just sort of getting on the same team and trying to figure something out, because it does look like you're trying to find a route out of a situation. Now, we've got this Two of Cups rooted down with the Nine of Wands in the upright. This is the Wounded Warrior card. So the Nine of Wands in the upright, when it's being rooted down by the Two of Cups, tells me that Perhaps Aries, you and a partner, a business partner, or a spouse, or somebody, or a best friend, what have you, are both trying to figure out how to stop dealing with the same challenge over and over again. Whether it be, the challenge in this relationship, whether it be the challenge, financial challenge, health challenges that you keep facing over and over again. It looks like you and yourself and someone else keep hitting that same wall over something. Now, again, it's going to be different for all of you. Some of you, this is going to be about the relationship. Others of you, this is going to be about business, finance, health. Again, it's just a general read, so it's different for all of you. So in week three, we have the Two of Pentacles here, rooted down by the Page of Cups in the upright. So week three of September, it looks like you're going to be, could be dealing with two different situations. Two of Pentacles is good because it's a fair, balanced energy. It's like this is harmony in the midst of change. If something is going on, we're able to, deal with it. If we're, t say, for example, if you're taking on a second job or you're doing something extra to make money, the Two of Pentacles lets you know that there's harmony in the midst of this change, because sometimes change can bring, disharmony, chaos, and people dropping the balls. That would be the Two of Pentacles in reverse. But when it's in the upright, this is where we're able to implement change, which is good. It seems like on some level, Aries, you need to bring in some kind of change into your life. And so for some of you, this could be an easy transition. If you've left your job, it could be an easy transition into a new job. If you've left your home, it could be an easy transition into a new home, that kind of thing. Even a breakup or something like that, it could be that both parties are in agreement, and you know what I mean? Things are moving along harmoniously and fairly. So it's rooted down here with the Page of Cups in the upright position. The Page of Cups is beautiful energy. I like the Page of Cups. Page of Cups can be incredibly sweet, unless he's reversed, then he can be cranky pants. But Page of Cups in the upright can often, well, first of all, it's a court card, could be representing a person. If it's representing a person, this is water energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Sun, Moon, or Rising, male or female. So it could be that you're getting messages maybe from a person who's incredibly shy, incredibly sweet, and could be coming towards you, could have a crush on you, that kind of thing. Page of Cups can sometimes indicate a child, or a childlike person. Sometimes the Page of Cups can indicate an apology. It can indicate many things. Somebody being incredibly sweet, somebody messaging you, like I said, or it could be an apology. And energies go both ways. This could be you apologizing or someone else apologizing to you. So now we're moving on to week four. We have the Six of Wands. This is really good, with Major Arcana, the Fool in the upright. So it looks like the month of September, Aries, sees you leaving on a high note. A Six of Wands is the card that represents, victory, and it represents a lot of attention being bestowed upon you. So it looks like you're trying something new, because it's rooted down with the Major Arcana, the Fool in the upright, which is about, it's that energy of trying something new, starting over, starting fresh, starting something we've never done before. It's taking that leap of faith. So for some of you, perhaps you're finding a really good victory in this new thing that you're doing. Aries loves to be the front runner. Aries loves to be the first one to try something. The Fool is very much like Aries energy. So it looks like, maybe you're having some level of victory in week three, and you're deciding to push it to the limit, and therefore you're getting this pass on the back, work well done, a lot of kudos to you. Others of you, this could be about finding victory with something new. The Fool represents starting on a new path, trying something new, figuring out, obviously you're trying to figure out a way out of this struggle with the Eight of Swords here. But it does look like all's well that ends well. In the end, it does look like you find your victory and you find your escape route. So that's kind of cool for you, Aries. And in closing, as usual, I will be pulling two cards, one for love and romance and the second one for career and finance. So the first one is for love and romance. You have Capricorn, Sun in Capricorn, steady as she goes. So perhaps if you're looking single and looking, the Capricorn could be your your person of interest. For others of you, this could be, you know, a strong Capricorn connection. Maybe that is your spouse. For others of you, you could find somebody when, you know, the moon is in Capricorn, or you could be introduced to the love of your life by a Capricorn. So now we're going to move on to career and finance for your second card. And what do we have here? We have Moon in Leo. So, Moon in Leo here, Aries. So it could be that when the Moon is in Leo, you could be getting a, you know, a financial boost or something like that. Or it could be because of a Leo, you could be expecting some kind of, you know, financial upturn. Or it could be a Leo business partner coming on the scene. What have you. But that's what I have for you, Aries. I really hope the reading helped you. If it did, please feel free to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you next time. Bye-bye.